Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to have a look at some current affair questions from January to May. These questions are basically one-liners. When you will have a glance at these questions, if this question will come in any exam, you will be able to attempt it very easily. And these questions are very important in all the examination, like in all the written examination as well as your interview. These questions are very important. So moving forward in the session, this is actually a like top 50 questions from Jan to May. It is actually a list of events that has happened in these months for the year 2021. So we'll move forward to the session and we'll move to our question number one, that is, which country is set to join as the sixth member of the Five Eyes Intelligence Network? And the answer to this question is Japan. So what is Five Eyes? Five Eyes is an intelligence network of five nations, namely Australia, Britain, Canada, New Zealand, and the US. And the collaborative network was formed to respond to the threats posed by North Korea and China. And as per media reports, the Japan has already provided intelligence to the US and UK on China's forceful detainment. Okay, so we'll move to question number two, that is, the first Khelo India Sports School of the Northeast India is situated in which city? The correct answer to this question is Shillong. So the Union Minister for Youth Affairs and Sports, who is it? It is Kiren Rijiju. He has recently launched the Assam Rifle Public School in Shillong. And by this school has become the first Khelo India Sports School of the Northeast India. And at present, nine sports schools have been approved across the country. The school aims to integrate sports with education, with the government bearing the expenses of athletes. So actually it is a very good initiative towards embankment of the sports in our country. We'll move forward to question number three, that is, Angamali Ajutha Sabari Rail Project. It was in news recently, and so the question is, where is it to be constructed, in which state? So the correct answer to this question is Kerala. See, the Union Cabinet has approved the like they have approved the use of fund from Kerala Infrastructure Investment Board for this rail project, and railway will undertake the construction and maintenance of the project. We'll move forward to the next question, that is, Siruvani Hills, which has been identified as a butterfly super hot spot, is located in which state? So the correct answer to this question is Tamil Nadu. So it was a 6-year study. It was conducted by Nature and Butterfly Society. The Siruvani Hill in the state of Tamil Nadu, it has been identified as a butterfly super hot spot. 40 out of 325 species found in Tamil Nadu are from the hill between 2015 and 2020. The 74% of the total species is found to be hill from the six families. And as per TNBSF, 25% of the state checklist species are found in a single area. It is to be like it can be identified as a hotspot. We'll move forward to question number five, that is, what is Khadi Prakritik, which was in the news recently? So Khadi Prakritik is a paint. It is actually India's first cow dung paint. It was developed by Khadi and Village Industries Commission. And it is an eco-friendly, non-toxic paint. Moving forward to the next question, that is, with reference to Star Streak air defense system, India has recently teamed up with which country? The correct answer to this question is United Kingdom. So India's Bharat Dynamics and Global Aerospace Company, they have signed an agreement to collaborate on the Star Streak defense system. Moving forward to the next question, that is, which country's Mars digger probe named the Mole was declared dead recently? And the correct answer to this question is USA. See, the Mars digger probe, it was named as a Mole. It was deployed on the Mars by NASA's InSight lander. The probe has been recently declared dead by scientists as it failed to burrow deep into Mars. Actually, it was trying since 2019 to dig deep and find the internal temperature of the Mars. And the lander, with the InSight lander, it will continue working till 2022. Question number eight, that is, who was the chairperson of the task force set up by Government of India on age of marriage for women? The correct answer to this question is Jaya Jetley. The Government of India, they have set up a task force under the chairmanship of Jaya Jetley to revisit the apt age of marriage of women. द केसेस ऑफ अंडर एज प्रेगनेंसी ऑफ द वुमेन्स हैव बीन टेकन अ कंसिडरेबल राइज. सो फॉर दिस दिस कमिटी वॉज सेटअप इन अकॉर्डेंस टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इंडिपेंडेंस डे स्पीच ऑन राइट एज फॉर मैरिज फॉर वुमेन. एंड रिसेंटली द रिपोर्ट हैज़ बीन सबमिटेड. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, दैट इज नेशनल गर्ल चाइल्ड डे हैज़ बीन सेलिब्रेटेड इन इंडिया फ्रॉम विच ईयर. द करेक्ट आंसर इज 2008. सी नेशनल गर्ल चाइल्ड डे इट हैज़ बीन सेलिब्रेटेड इन इंडिया ऑन जनवरी 24 फ्रॉम द ईयर 2008. टू मार्क द नेशनल गर्ल चाइल्ड डे द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेस अवेयरनेस कैंपेन्स अंडर बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ स्कीम. एंड सी दिस डे इज एन एक्चुअली इनिशिएटिव ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट एंड इट एम्स टू फोकस ऑन सोल्यूशन फॉर जेंडर बायस एंड चैलेंजेस फेस्ड बाई गर्ल्स इन इंडियन सोसाइटी. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, दैट इज स्टार्ट स्ट्रेटेजिक आर्म रिडक्शन ट्रीटी इज एन एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन विच टू कंट्रीज. आई गेस मोस्ट ऑफ द यू विल नो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, दैट इज USA एंड रशिया. स्टार्ट इज इट इज अ बायलेटरल एग्रीमेंट साइंड इन 2010 बिटवीन यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एंड रशिया. एंड द ट्रीटी इज एम्फसाइज ऑन द रिडक्शन एंड लिमिटेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक न्यूक्लियर आर्म बाई टू कंट्रीज एंड इट इज सेट टू एक्सपायर एंड रशिया लोअर हाउस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट अप्रूव्ड द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द ट्रीटी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 इज व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ इंडियाज इनिशिएटिव टू डिलीवर कोविड 19 वैक्सीन टू फ्रेंडली कंट्रीज. द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज वैक्सीन मैत्री. सो इंडिया हैज डिस्पैच्ड 5 लाख डोजेज ऑफ कोविशील्ड वैक्सीन टू श्रीलंका एज अ ग्रांट असिस्टेंट अंडर इट्स वैक्सीन मैत्री इनिशिएटिव एंड दिस वॉज लॉन्च ऑन जनवरी 20th. एंड अंडर द इनिशिएटिव इंडिया हैज ऑलरेडी डिलीवर्ड नियरली 5 मिलियन डोजेज टू 7 कंट्रीज इन द नेबरहुड इंक्लूडिंग मालदीव्स नेपाल मॉरिशस म्यांमार सियाचेल्स भूटान एक्सेट्रा. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 12, दैट इज अरुण हाइड्रो पावर प्रोजेक्ट विच वॉज मेकिंग इन न्यूज रिसेंटली इज बींग कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन विच कंट्री. द करेक्ट आंसर इज नेपाल. सी इट वॉज अ प्रोजेक्ट बाई इन्वेस्टमेंट बोर्ड नेपाल एंड इट वॉज शेयर बाई प्राइम मिनिस्टर KP शर्मा ओली. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. जंस्कार वैली विच वॉज मेकिंग न्यूज रिसेंटली इज लोकेटेड इन विच स्टेट. द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज लद्दाख. सो द 13 डेज लॉन्ग खेलो इंडिया जंस्कर विंटर स्पोर्ट एंड यूथ फेस्टिवल कंक्लूडेड एट जंस्कर वैली ऑफ द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ लद्दाख एंड देवर इनाग्रेटेड ऑन जनवरी 21st एट पैडूम इन जंस्कर ऑफ कारगिल डिस्ट्रिक्ट बाई यूनियन स्पोर्ट्स एंड यूथ अफेयर मिनिस्टर किरेन रिजिजू. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. विच इज द लार्जेस्ट कॉम्बैट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द इंडियन नेवी विच वॉज हेल्ड इन द इंडियन ओशियन रीजन. एक्चुअली आई हैव कवर्ड ऑल द मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइजेज इन अर्लियर वीडियो, प्लीज हैव अ लुक एट इट एंड द डिस्क्रिप्शन इज ऑल्सो गिवन. द लिंक इज एक्चुअली गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. सो द आंसर टू करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ट्रॉपेक्स. वॉट इज ट्रॉपेक्स? इट इज थिएटर लेवल ऑपरेशनल रेडीनेस एक्सरसाइज एंड इट वॉज हेल्ड इन इंडियन ओशियन रीजन एंड इट इज एक्चुअली अ मंथ लॉन्ग डिले. इट इंक्लूड्स जॉइंट एक्सरसाइजेज बाई शिप्स एयरक्राफ्ट एंड अदर सेट्स ऑफ इंडियन एयरफोर्स इंडियन आर्मी एंड इंडियन कोस्ट गार्ड एंड इंडियन नेवी. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, दैट इज विच कंट्री हैज अनाउंसड अ सीरीज ऑफ सैंक्शन ऑन म्यांमार मिलिट्री लीडर्स. द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज USA. सो द US President Joe Biden has announced, they have announced a series of sanctions on the military leaders of Myanmar. And this follows the military action to overthrow a democratically elected leadership. Now we'll move to question number 16, that is anti-radicalism bill which is seen in news recently is associated with which country. The correct answer to this question is France. Actually the anti-radicalism bill of France, it has been aimed to strengthen oversight of mosque, school and sports club and it has been put to vote in nation's law making assembly. And actually this bill has been proposed to rid France of radical Islamists and ensure respect of for French values and it is actually their president's landmark project. Moving forward to question number 17, that is which Indian state assembly played the national anthem after almost 60 years. The correct answer to this question is Nagaland. So the national anthem was played inside the Nagaland State Assembly for the first time almost 60 years after Nagaland attained statehood. And Nagaland attained statehood on 1st of December 1963, and it was 16th state of the Indian Union. Though playing the national anthem, see, it is not mandatory in state assemblies, but this practice is usually followed in many states. Moving forward to question number 18, that is, who won the Australian Open in 2021? And the correct answer to this question is Naomi Osaka. And she is from Japan, and she defeated Jennifer Brady, and it was her fourth Grand Slam, and she is only 23 years old, and she is presently ranked number 2 in tennis rankings. Moving forward to question number 19, which Indian personality started the Prabuddh Bharat Journal in 1896? The correct answer to this question is Swami Vivekananda. See, Swami Vivekananda started the Prabuddh Bharat, a monthly journal of the Ramakrishna Order in 1896 to spread the message of India's spiritual knowledge. Moving forward to question number 20, that is, how many satellites were launched by the ISRO using its PSLV C-51 rocket? The correct answer is 19. See, PSLV C-51, it was lifted from Sriharikota launch pad. It was carrying 19 satellites from Brazil, USA, and India, with Brazil's 637 kilogram optical earth observation satellite Amazonia 1 as its primary passenger, and this was the first commercial mission of New Space India Limited. We'll move to question number 21, that is, the Starship mission was developed by which country? And the correct answer is US, and it is developed by SpaceX. We all know who is the CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk. And actually, the system, the Starship mission, it is a fully reusable two-stage to orbit heavy lift launch vehicle, and the system comprises of a booster stage called Super Heavy. The second stage of the vehicle is called Starship. The next question is, which country has recently signed pact with India for purchase of BrahMos missile? The correct answer is Philippines. What is BrahMos? BrahMos is a medium range supersonic cruise missile. It was designed actually jointly by BrahMos Aerospace. It is a joint venture company set up by India's DRDO and Russia's Mashinostroyenia, and it can be launched from submarine, ship, plane, or land-based platforms. Next question is, what was the theme of National Safety Day 2021? The correct answer is Sadak Suraksha. And when is National Safety Day celebrated? It is observed on March 4, and it is observed every year with the aim of creating awareness among people with respect to safety measures. And the celebration this year have been spread over a week, and National Safety Week will be observed from March 4 to March 10th. Now we'll move forward to question number 24, that is, the Simlipal Biosphere Reserve is located in which Indian state? The correct answer to this question is Odisha. Simlipal Biosphere Reserve actually comprises of Simlipal National Park cum Tiger Reserve along with its adjoining area, and it is located in the eastern end of the Eastern Ghats in Odisha. Next question is, which country is the chair of BRICS 2021? And the correct answer is India. And it has also held its first meeting from March 9 to 11. Next question is, which ministry has moved the National Capital Territory of Delhi Bill 2021 in the Lok Sabha? Actually, it's a very, very conflicting bill, very controversial bill actually, and it is the Ministry of Home Affairs. And the Union Ministry of Home Affairs has recently moved this bill in Lok Sabha, and actually this bill seeks to redefine the meaning of Government of Delhi as Lieutenant Governor of Delhi. And the bill seeks to give discretionary power to Lieutenant Governor of Delhi in aspect in which the Legislative Assembly of Delhi is empowered to make laws. Now we'll move forward to next question, that is, what is the name of telemedicine service offered by the Union Health Ministry? And the correct answer is e-Sanjeevani. See, actually, it's a digital service, it's a telemedicine service, and it is operational in 31 states. And the service include two variants, one for doctor to doctor and one for outpatient services. And Tamil Nadu tops the number of consultations. The next question is, फ्रॉम विच कंट्री द टॉर्च रिले फॉर द टोक्यो समर ओलंपिक हैज कमेंस्ड? द करेक्ट आंसर इज जापान. एंड सी द ओलंपिक वर सपोज टू हेल्ड ऑन 2020 एंड दे हैव बीन पोस्टपोन टू 2021. एंड नाउ द टॉर्च रिले हैज़ बिगेन. दिस रिले इज सेट टू मेक इट्स वे अक्रॉस जापान फॉर अ ड्यूरेशन ऑफ 121 डेज एंड वुड कल्मिनेट द स्टार्ट ऑफ गेम्स इन जुलाई. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन विच स्टेट इज वायनाड वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी सिचुएटेड? द करेक्ट आंसर इज केरला. द सेंचुरी इज लोकेटेड इन केरला इन वेस्टर्न घाट्स. एंड द एक्चुअली अ सर्वे वॉज कनेक्ट अ ड्रैगन फ्लाई सर्वे वॉज कंडक्टेड एंड इट रिसेंटली कंक्लूडेड देयर. एंड द सर्वे टुक नियरली 4 months एंड 84 स्पीसीज ऑफ ओडोनेट्स वर स्पॉटेड. वॉट इज ओडोनेट्स? दे आर अ ऑर्डर ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स कंप्राइजिंग ड्रैगन फ्लाइज एंड डैमसिल फ्लाइज. दिस इज एक्चुअली अ लोकेशन ऑफ वायनाड वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. नाउ विल मूव फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 30. दैट इज वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ इंडियाज फर्स्ट इंडिजीनियस एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर? एंड द आंसर इज विक्रांत. एंड इंडियाज फर्स्ट इंडिजीनियस एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर विक्रांत. इट इज मैनुफैक्चर्ड एट कोचिन शिपयार्ड लिमिटेड इन कोचिंग. And it is expected to commission by early 2021. Now we'll move to question number 31. That is, which armed forces has decided to employ retired combat dog as therapy dogs? The correct answer is ITBP. That is Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force. And they have decided to utilize the services of retired combat canines and dog as therapy dogs. And this is the first time in India that retired canine elements are being used to serve the soldiers. Now we'll move forward to question number 32. That is, the Mahendragiri Hill ecosystem is situated in which state? See, the question from ecosystem, biosphere reserve and wildlife sanctuaries, there is a one or two short short question in every examination. So the correct answer to this question is Odisha. And it's a beautiful place actually, the Mahendragiri Hills. And it is actually second highest mountain peak of Odisha. And we have discussed earlier also the Simlipal Biosphere Reserve is Odisha's first biosphere reserve, and the state government of Odisha has proposed to form the state's second biosphere reserve at Mahendragiri. And it is a hill ecosystem having rich biodiversity located in southern part of the state. We'll move forward to the next question. That is question number 33. Blue flag is a globally recognized eco-label certification provided to beaches from which country? The correct answer is Denmark. See, blue flag is a globally recognized eco-label certification provided to beaches. It is based on water quality, environment, education, conservation and safety and services. And actually recently the fishermen of Odisha have been staging protest against the Odisha state move to get blue flag certification for 5 beaches. Actually the fishermen have demanded an alternated sea mouth to anchor their boat before being removed from the beaches. Now we'll move forward to question number 34. That is, when is the International Day of Human Space Flight observed? The correct answer is April 12. See, every year April 12 is observed as the International Day of Human Space Flight by United Nations. And it was declared by the UN by a way of resolution in 2011. And this year marks 60 years of the first human space flight for exploration of space by a Soviet cosmonaut named Yuri Gagarin. Now we'll move forward to the next question. That is, Luna 25 is the name of lunar mission of which country? The correct answer is Russia. See, Russia has unveiled a new series of space lunar missions, and the first of those missions are named as Luna 25, and they are scheduled to launch this October. And there is a fact that Russia has a 45-year drought of moon landings. Now we'll move forward to question number 36. That is, Vera Gedroyt, who featured in Google Doodle, she was actually a military surgeon, is from which country? And the correct answer is Russia. She is also regarded as the country's first female military surgeon and one of the world's first female professor of surgery. And she volunteered during the Russo-Japanese War in 1904. Moving forward to the question number 37, that is, which country is set to build its own space station by 2030? And the correct answer to this question is Russia. See, the Russian space agency Roscosmos, it is set for building its own space station and aims to launch the same by year 2030. Now this project is एक्सपेक्टेड टू एंड रशियाज कॉपरेशन विद द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका फॉर मोर देन 2 डिकेड्स अबाउट द ISS, दैट इज इंटरनेशनल स्पेस स्टेशन. नाउ विल मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 38, दैट इज माई लाइफ इन फुल वर्क फैमिली एंड आर फ्यूचर इज अ मेमोयर ऑफ विच इंडियन पर्सनैलिटी. द आंसर इज इंदिरा नोई. इंदिरा नोई वॉज एक्चुअली अ फॉर्मर पेप्सिको CEO. Now we'll move forward to question number 39, that is in which year the 73rd constitutional amendment on panchayati raj was enacted in India. The correct answer to this question is 1992. See, in 1992 there was a 73rd amendment and it came into force on 24th April. Under this amendment the state government were allowed to make provision for organizing village panchayat as unit of self governance. And every year 24th April is observed as National Panchayati Raj Day since 2010. And in three-tier panchayat system, there are district panchayat elected and nominated, panchayat unit council, they are elected, village panchayat elected, Gram Sabha, which is an advisory body. Now we'll move forward to question number 40, that is, to counter China's dominance, trade ministers of India, Japan and Australia launched SCRI. What is SCRI? It is Supply Chain Resilience Initiative. So, in a move to counter China's dominance of supply chain in Indo-Pacific region, trade ministers of India, Japan and Australia on Tuesday launched Supply Chain Resilience Initiative. Initially, SCRI will focus on sharing best practice on supply chain resilience, investment promotion events and buyer-selling matching events. Now, we'll move forward to our last 10 questions, that is question number 41. What is S&P Global Ratings new GDP forecast for India? It is actually 9.8%, and it has been actually slashed. Earlier it was 11%, and after this second wave of corona it has been revised to 9.8%, and the agency stated that the second wave could weaken the economic recovery. Now we'll move forward to question number 42, that is what is Atman AI, and it was actually in news recently. What is it? So it is a tool to detect COVID-19. DRDO and CAIR, that is Center for Artificial Intelligence and Robotics, they have created an artificial intelligence algorithm to detect COVID-19 from chest x-ray. And this tool is used for chest x-ray screening, and it has shown an accuracy rate of 96.73%, and it can be used to rapidly diagnose and effectively treat COVID-19 patient. Now we'll move forward to question number 43, that is what is the name of autism spectrum disorder linked to difficulty with social interaction? The correct answer to this question is Asperger syndrome. It actually came to, like, it is an autism spectrum disorder, and it was revealed by Tesla CEO, that is billionaire Elon Musk. Actually he revealed in an episode of Saturday Night Live that he has Asperger syndrome. So what is it? It is an autism spectrum disorder. It is linked to experiencing difficulty with social interaction in spite of having strong verbal and cognitive skills. Now we'll move forward to question number 44. That is which state has launched the Mahtari Dular Yojana scheme? So the correct answer is Chhattisgarh. The state government of Chhattisgarh has launched this scheme. Under this scheme, the state would bear the education expenses of the children who have lost parent to COVID-19. And a stipend will be given to such children who are studying in class 1 to 8 for 500 and 1000 per month for classes 9 to 12. And it is applicable for children studying in both government and private schools. Now we'll move forward to question number 45, that is which organization is developing the JUICE spacecraft? Actually the ESA, the European Space Agency, in association with Airbus Defender and Space, they are developing the JUICE spacecraft, that is the Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer. It is an interplanetary spacecraft which has a mission to study three of Jupiter's moons, namely Ganymede, Callisto and Europa. And the mission is set to be launched in June 2022. And after an 88-month journey, the spacecraft would reach Jupiter in October 2029. Now we'll move over to question number 46, that is which is the only aircraft carrier being operated in India? The answer is INS Vikramaditya. India's only aircraft carrier is INS Vikramaditya, a modified Kiev class 44,500 ton एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर एंड फ्लैगशिप ऑफ द इंडियन नेवी, एंड इंडिया बॉट द एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर फ्रॉम रशिया एंड इट जॉइंड द नेवल फ्लीट 7 ईयर्स एगो। देन इंडियन नेवी ऑपरेट्स MiG-29K मैरीटाइम फाइटर फ्रॉम द डेक ऑफ दिस एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर। नाउ विल मूव ओवर टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 47, दैट इज द फ्रीडम ऑफ नेविगेशन ऑपरेशन हैज़ बीन कंडक्टेड बाई विच कंट्री इन द इंडियन ओशियन रीजन। द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज USA। सी द US नेवी हैज़ रिसेंटली कैरीड आउट अ फ्रीडम ऑफ नेविगेशन ऑपरेशन इन द इंडियन वाटर्स इन इंडियन ओशियन रीजन नियर लक्षद्वीप आईलैंड। एनी मैरीटाइम ऑपरेशन इन इंडियन वाटर रिक्वायर प्रायर अप्रूवल फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, बट द US नेवल फोर्सेज हैड कंडक्टेड दिस ऑपरेशन विदाउट द कंसेंट ऑफ इंडियन अथॉरिटीज। सी दिस मैटर हैज़ बीन रेज्ड एंड इट इज़ बीन डिस्कस्ड। नाउ विल मूव फॉरवर्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 48, दैट इज विच रेंज डज इंडस रिवर ओरिजिनेट्स फ्रॉम। द करेक्ट आंसर इज नॉर्दर्न स्लोप ऑफ कैलाश रेंज। सी द इंडस रिवर ओरिजिनेट्स इन द नॉर्दर्न स्लोप ऑफ कैलाश रेंज इन तिब्बत नियर लेक मानसरोवर, एंड इट फॉलोज द नॉर्थ वेस्टर्ली क्रॉस थ्रू तिब्बत एंड फ्रॉम इट इंडियंस इंडियन टेरिटरी इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर। सी देर इज लाइक अ श्योर शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम रिवर सिस्टम ऑल्सो इन मैनी एग्जामिनेशन, बी इट SSC, UPSC, NDA, देर इज ऑलवेज अ श्योर शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम रिवर सिस्टम। नाउ विल मूव ओवर टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 49, दैट इज विच इज द डीपेस्ट ओशियनिक ट्रेंच ऑफ द अर्थ। द करेक्ट आंसर इज मैरियाना ट्रेंच। द इट इज लोकेटेड इन वेस्टर्न पैसिफिक ओशियन, इट इज द डीपेस्ट ओशियनिक ट्रेंच ऑन अर्थ। रिसेंटली द लोकेशंस वेयर द सी फ्लोर बॉटम आउट इन पैसिफिक, अटलांटिक, इंडियन, आर्कटिक एंड सदर्न ओशियन वर मैट बाई 5 डीप एक्सपेडिशन, एंड इट वॉज फाउंड दैट द डीपेस्ट ट्रेंच इन द इंडियन ओशियन इट वॉज एट अ डेप्थ ऑफ 7,187 मीटर एंड इट इज 387 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम वेयर प्रीवियस डेटा हैज सजेस्टेड द डीपेस्ट पॉइंट कुड बी। सो नाउ विल मूव टू आवर लास्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 50, दैट इज विच कंट्री हैज़ लॉन्च द सैटेलाइट आर्कटिका M? द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज रशिया। सी द रशिया स्पेस एजेंसी हैज़ लॉन्च इट्स सैटेलाइट आर्कटिका M एंड दिस सैटेलाइट इज इंटेंडेड टू मॉनिटर द क्लाइमेट इन द आर्कटिक रीजन। इन द रीसेंट पास्ट रशिया हैज़ बीन टेकिंग कीन इंटरेस्ट इन एक्सप्लोरिंग आर्कटिक रीजन एंड इज सीकिंग टू डेवलप द एनर्जी रिच रीजन फॉर द नेशंस डेवलपमेंटल इंटरेस्ट। सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन।